हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सोनू यादव। टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज एपोप्टोसिस। इट इज़ अ यूनिक फॉर्म ऑफ सेल डेथ। इट इज जेनेटिकली रेगुलेटेड, दैट्स वाई नोन एज प्रोग्राम सेल डेथ। इट मेन पर्पज इज टू एलिमिनेट सेल्स दैट आर नो लॉन्गर नीडेड इन ऑर्डर टू मेंटेन अ कॉन्स्टेंट पॉपुलेशन। सो apoptosis, it eliminates cells that are injured beyond repair without eliciting a host reaction, thus limiting collateral tissue damage. So, coming on to the definition, apoptosis, it is a type of cell death that is induced by tightly regulated suicide program in which cells destined to die, they activate intrinsic enzymes which will degrade cells' own genomic DNA, nuclear and cytoplasmic proteins, and they form apoptotic bodies which have intact plasma membrane. And the plasma membrane, the surface components are altered so as to produce feed me and eat me signals for phagocytes. As a result, the dead cell and its fragments are rapidly removed before the contents leak out. So there is no inflammatory reaction. Now, coming on to the causes of apoptosis. They are divided into two groups, physiological situations and pathological situations. Now, coming on to the physiological situations. During development, all the excess cells are removed by a process known as apoptosis. And on hormone withdrawal, there is involution of hormone-dependent tissue. It is also an example of apoptosis. Cell turnover in proliferating cell population is also by apoptosis. And the harmful self-reactive lymphocytes, they are removed by a process of apoptosis. Death of host cells that have served their useful purpose are removed by process of apoptosis. So these all are the example of physiological situation leading to apoptosis. Now, coming on to the pathological situations. The examples are DNA damage, accumulation of misfolded proteins. Apoptosis can be induced during certain infections, and pathological atrophy in parenchymal organs after duct obstruction, for example, in pancreas, parotid gland, and kidney. Now, coming on to the mechanism of apoptosis. Survival or apoptosis of many cells depend upon the balance between two opposite sets of signal, that is balance between pro-apoptotic proteins and anti-apoptotic proteins. Pro-apoptotic proteins, they are the proteins which favor apoptosis. Which favors apoptosis. That is, it is a form of cell death. Anti-apoptotic proteins, which prevent, block apoptosis. So, survival or apoptosis of many cells depends upon the balance between pro-apoptotic proteins and anti-apoptotic proteins. Now, there are more than 20 members of the BCL family, which can be divided into three groups based on their function. That is pro-apoptotic, anti-apoptotic and BCL2. They are sensors. Now, coming on to anti-apoptotic proteins. they have four BH domains called BH1 to 4. The examples are BCL2, BCLXL and MCL1. They are present in outer mitochondrial membrane or in the cytosol and endoplasmic reticulum membranes. Their function is to keep the mitochondrial outer membrane impermeable. This is their function, to keep the mitochondrial outer membrane impermeable in order to prevent the leakage of cytochrome C and other death inducing proteins into the cytosol in order to prevent apoptosis. Now, coming on to the pro-apoptotic protein. They contain first three BH domains, that's why known as BH1, 2, 3. The examples are BEX and BEC. They oligomerize within the outer mitochondrial membrane and enhance its permeability. Form a channel in outer mitochondrial membrane that allows cytochrome C leakage from the intermembranous space, helps in apoptosis. Now, regulated apoptosis initiator, that is sensors. They have one BH domain, the third of the four BH domain, therefore known as BH3 only proteins. The examples are BAD, BIM, BID, Puma and Noxa, modulated by sensors of cellular stress and damage. That is, whenever there is stress and damage, they will lead to activation of these sensors, apoptosis induced sensors, and they can initiate apoptosis. In apoptosis, the main role is played by caspases. Apoptosis results from activation of enzyme called caspases, present as proenzyme, that is in inactivated form. So to induce apoptosis, first caspases has to be converted into activated form. Now coming on to the pathways, that is the mechanism. The mechanism of apoptosis is divided into two pathways, mitochondrial pathway, also known as intrinsic pathway, death receptor pathway, also known as extrinsic pathway. In both the pathways, there are two phases, that is initiation phase and execution phase. Similarly, in death receptor pathway, there is initiation phase and execution phase. Execution phase is common in both the pathways. So we will discuss the common pathway after discussing initiation phase of mitochondrial pathway as well as death receptor pathway. Now coming on to the mitochondrial pathway, that is intrinsic pathway of apoptosis. So whenever there is mitochondrial damage, and the factors which lead to mitochondrial damage are the various stimulus that lead to cell injury, that is deprivation of growth factor or survival signal, radiation, various cytotoxic anti-cancer drugs, free radicals, accumulation of excessive amount of misfolded protein, increased intracellular free calcium, all these factors lead to mitochondrial damage, which will lead to activation of sensors. The examples are BIM, BID, Noxa. Now the sensor, activation of sensor leads to activation of pro-apoptotic proteins that is Bex and Beck. And there is block of anti-apoptotic proteins, that is BCL2 and BCL-XL. So, first of all, there is mitochondrial damage which will lead to activation of sensors, that is BIMBID. Activation of sensor lead to activation of pro-apoptotic protein and there is blockage of anti-apoptotic proteins. This will create a channel in the mitochondrial membrane and there is release of several mitochondrial protein, that is APAF1, apoptotic protease activation factor. And this will lead to formation of a complex known as apoptosome. And this will lead to activation of procaspase 9 into caspase 9. This all is an initiation phase, starting from mitochondrial damage to activation of caspase 9 is an initiation phase of mitochondrial pathway. Now this is followed by execution phase, which is a common pathway in mitochondrial as well as death receptor pathway. Now we are going to discuss the initiation phase of death receptor pathway. So it is also known as extrinsic pathway, as it is initiated by extracellular signals. Many cells express death receptor on the surface of plasma membrane. The death receptors are the member of TNF family, that is tumor necrosis factor. The well-known death receptors are, the examples are type 1 TNF and a related protein called FAS, that is CD95. The binding ligand for FAS is called FAS ligand and CD95 ligand. Now coming on to the initiation phase. The CD95 and FAS, they bind to their ligand, CD95 ligand or FAS ligand. Now their cytoplasmic domain binds with the adapter protein, that is a death domain. And now this FADD binds to procaspase 8 and lead to activation of caspase 8, that is the initiator caspase of death domain pathway. This will followed by execution phase of death domain pathway and this is the common pathway. Now coming on to the execution phase, that is the common pathway for mitochondrial as well as death receptor pathway. In initiation phase of both the pathways, that is in mitochondrial pathway, there is activation of initiation caspase 9 and in death receptor pathway, there is activation of initiator caspase 8, which is followed by execution phase, that is the activation of caspase 3 and 6. This is known as executioner caspase and this will lead to, in mitochondrial pathway, there is activation of endonucleases which will lead to nuclear fragmentation and ultimately results in apoptosis. In the similar way, in death receptor pathway, the activation of caspases 3 and 6 lead to breakdown of cytoskeleton and result in apoptosis. Now, this is the picture showing mitochondrial pathway and death receptor pathway. They have two phases, that is initiation phase and execution phase. Execution phase is common for both mitochondrial pathway as well as death receptor pathway. In mitochondrial pathway, the initiator caspase is caspase 9. There is activation of caspase 9 and in death receptor pathway, there is activation of initiator caspase 8, which is followed by execution phase. In execution phase, there is activation of caspase 3 and 6, which ultimately lead to apoptosis. That is a form of cell death. And there is phagocytosis of these apoptotic cells or cell bodies, usually by macrophages. Now, coming on to the morphological and biochemical changes in apoptosis, there is cell shrinkage, that is, cell size is reduced, and the cytoplasm is dense and eosinophilic. There is chromatin condensation and formation of cytoplasmic blebs and apoptotic bodies. And these apoptotic bodies will have an intact plasma membrane, as there is no leakage of content. So there is no inflammatory reaction. As a result, there is no collateral damage. In H and E stained tissue, the apoptotic cell appear as a round or oval mass of intensely eosinophilic cytoplasm with fragments of dense nuclear chromatin. Now, there are certain disorders which are associated with dysregulated apoptosis. It can be disorders with reduced apoptosis or disorders with increased apoptosis. So the examples for disorder with reduced apoptosis, that is cancer and autoimmune disease. In cancer, the examples are, if there is DNA damage and accumulation of misfolded protein, if these cells are not removed by apoptosis, it will lead to malignant transformation. The example is follicular lymphoma. Now, disorders with increased apoptosis, neurodegenerative diseases, ischemic injury, and death of virus infected cells. These are few examples of dysregulated apoptosis. Now, diagnosis or detection of apoptosis. Electrophoresis of genomic DNA, it will give a step ladder pattern, and in vivo detection of apoptosis can be done by tunnel technique, that is terminal deoxynucleotide transferase biotin, DUTP, NIC, and labeling. Chromatin condensation can be seen on HNE stain, acridin orange stain, etc. And estimation of cytosolic cytochrome C, annexin 5, and activated caspase also help in detection of apoptosis. Propiodine iodine assay by flow cytometry or fluorescent microscopy. So these all are the methods of detection of apoptosis. This is all about apoptosis.